Let's solve this differential equation. We have 1 half dy dx is equal to square root of y plus 1 times cosine x. And we also know y of pi is equal to 0. So be sure to solve for that constant. And I will have to talk about when we should solve for that constant in this video. Okay, let's go ahead and do our usual business. Let's go ahead, multiply dx on both sides. And I would also like to divide both sides by square root of y plus 1. And on the left hand side, let me just put this down as 1 over square root of y plus 1 like this. Okay, to clean things up on the left hand side, 1 times 1 is just 1. And we'll write this down as 1 over, put a 2 in the front, 1 over 2 square root of y plus 1. And we have the dy here. And that's equal to, on the right hand side, we just have cosine x dx. And we're ready to integrate, right? Because all the y's and all the x, they are in the right place. What's the integral of 1 over 2 square root of y plus 1? This right here is just going to be square root of y plus 1. Because a few ways you can do it, of course you can use u substitution, that u is equal to y plus 1, and go to the usual step, right? But I would suggest you guys to do it this way. Look at the inside, and you know the derivative of y plus 1 is just 1, so you don't have to divide or multiply by any constants. And you know the general form, 1 over 2 square root of something is going to give you square root of something, okay? And the best way to do it is, you integrate this in your head, put down an answer, just like this, and differentiate the answer and see if you can get back to this. Okay, let's go ahead and do that. Differentiate square root of y plus 1, we first get 1 over 2 square root of the inside, right, y plus 1. And you multiply by the derivative inside, by the chain rule. The derivative of y plus 1 is just 1, and you get back to the original. Okay, so right here, this is it. You don't have to worry about the plus constant on the left-hand side. We can just write this down. This is equal to, and the integral of cosine x is positive sine x. Okay, let's write this down. And let me just write down plus c1 right here. And let me emphasize that the plus c1, it's after the sine x. So let me use the parentheses right here to close it, to emphasize that. Okay, now we are pretty much done with the integration part, with the solving part for the differential equation. And because we're given this initial value, in this case, I would like to plug in x is pi, and that will give us y will be 0. I would like to plug in these values right here to solve for c. It's because if you isolate the y first, and then you want to solve for c later on, you wouldn't know if c should be positive or negative. Let me just do it the way I want to show you guys right here. I would like to solve for the c now, and I will show you guys what I mean by we wouldn't know if c is negative or not later on. Okay, plugging 0 into this y here, we have 0 here. Let me get the right color. 0 and then plus 1, and then that's inside of the square root. And this is equal to, we have the sine x is pi, and we close that, and then we add a c. Well, technically, we're just using the c right here, so you don't need to label the c1, just the c. Okay, 0 plus 1 is 1, square root of 1 is just 1. This is equal to sine of pi is 0, and then plus c. So of course, you see c is equal to 1, and you're pretty much done. So here you have square root of y plus 1 is equal to sine of x. C, in this case, as you can see, it's positive 1, right? So we add a 1 after that. At the end, this is not bad to do, so we'll do it. We would like to isolate y. So let's go ahead, square both sides. They cancel, and we will have y plus 1 is equal to sine of x plus 1 inside of this big parentheses and square that. And of course, we have to just subtract 1 on both sides, and we see that y is equal to sine of x and then plus 1, and then square that, and then minus 1. Here is the answer. Okay? Right, so real quick, imagine if you isolate the y first. And this is where the c was, right? So if you isolate the y first, you have y is equal to sine of x plus the c, which we don't know what it is. And you square that, this is my sine of x, and then minus 1 after that. Imagine if you get this first, and you plug in these values, 0 into y, and this is going to give you, this is sine of pi for the x, and you add a c after that, and you square that, and then minus 1. You see, this is 0, and sine of pi is 0 plus c, so it's just c inside. We have c squared, this is equal to c squared, and we have the minus 1. You can add 1 on both sides, you have c squared is equal to 1. You see, if you isolate the y first earlier, you end up with c squared is equal to 1. And are you going to say c is 1 or c is equal to negative 1? Well, to decide, you actually have to look back to this part of the equation. So you have to know that right here, c has to be positive 1. So this right here, it wasn't preferred, that's why I didn't show you guys this right here. A quick summary is that whenever you can solve for c easily, you go ahead and do it. And that's what I did right here. I solve for the c right away, and then I isolate the y after that. And this is it.